We're live here in quiet Pullman, Washington, except it's far from quiet right now at Martin Stadium. Before we head down to the field for the coin toss, we'd like to remind you this game is brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coke tastes, zero calories. Enjoy everything. Washington State has been waiting all week for this one. Get ready, folks. The opening kickoff is finally here. He got hit hard. James, a guy you really have to game plan for if you're a defensive coach. And we sat down with the coaches this week, and they know, they look at him, they look at that offensive line, and they know they're in for a long day.
Well, it's going to be a tough challenge for this defense. One thing that they, I think, have to do is commit numbers to the line of scrimmage. They've got to be able to be willing to take chances, put an eighth, sometimes ninth guy up close to the line of scrimmage and force this quarterback to try to have to beat them by throwing the ball through the air. Otherwise, it could be a long day for this defense.
You obviously have to worry about him as a ball carrier, but he showed here that you have to be concerned about him as a receiver as well. He's got good hands, and you know he's good in the open field.
He's at the 40. He's at the 30. And they bring him down at the 17. Go to the screen here, and the halfback's got it. Touchdown, Oregon!
They can't hold me, coach!
These guys need to be aware this aerial attack is capable of making some big plays. They've got to get on their toes.
Tacks on the extra point.
So a short three-play, 72-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
Well, Brad, right now this offense is hot, and they also took advantage of some mistakes there by the defense.
They line up to kick this one away. Butler from the three. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line.
So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today.
The 38.
Getting him the ball in the passing game creates real havoc for the defense. There aren't many linebackers who can stay with him in coverage, that's for sure.
Out of bounds at the 40. Screen. He gets hit out of bounds around the 45-yard line. The screen pass goes nowhere.
Well, you got to take your hat off to the defense. All week, they preached over and over again how they were not going to let this kid use his speed in the open field, and they really shut him down that time.
And they push him out at the 26-yard line.
Brad, let's see if this offense can maintain the rhythm that they established on that last drive. Not just putting points on the board, but driving the length of the field to be able to eventually put points up. I think that's going to be important for them to try to keep that confidence going here on this drive.
Inside the 30, to the 10. Touchdown, Ducks. He splits the uprights with the extra point. Oregon is lining up to kick this one off. From from the 7. He's out to the 30. Tackle made at the 40-yard line.
It's not quite a blowout, but unless they do something here, it might turn into one.
Graves on play action, and he throws it away.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
He's pushed out of bounds at about the 49. They'll spread the field with 5 wide. Tackled after a decent pickup.
It's a nice read by the quarterback to keep the ball and pick up some yardage.
They spread the field in the gun with 5 wide receivers. Steps out of bounds at about the 47-yard line. Complete. It's the junior. And he shoved out of bounds at the 28-yard line.
He made a really good move at the line of scrimmage. Sometimes all you need to do is throw off the defender's timing just a little bit at the start of the play.
Throws complete. He's hammered. He's tackled around the 24-yard line.
If these defenders continue to exploit the O-line like that, it's going to be a long day for this running back.
And this play is number 8 on the drive.
Watch
number 12. Stop your whining. Throws complete. He's got space to work. And he hits him hard at the 2.
Job of finding the space to run and just bursting in for 6.
And he adds the extra point. Rollins gets set to kick this one away. Taken from the 3-yard line. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line.
Oregon staff was talking all week long that this offense wanted to get off to a strong start, and they have.
They have. They talked about building that momentum early in the game and then trying to be able to hold on into the second half, where they've gotten off to a great start so far.
So their last drive resulted in 6 points. Do you think we'll see the same result on this one?
They ran the ball extremely well on their last drive, and until this defense figures out how to stop it, I think they'll have no problem moving the ball down the field.
Oregon is up 7. Has some daylight. Nice run there. And they make the stop around the 46-yard line. He's taken down at the 48-yard line. So the option play goes for a short gain there.
The halfback took the option and did what he could with it. He didn't get far, but he picked up the first down.
brought down in the open field. He's at the 30, the 10. He's all the way. Touchdown. And that's his second touchdown of the day.
You know, this guy's got two touchdowns. I think it's time to make an adjustment and maybe try to start to spy him. Whether you use a linebacker or a safety, somebody who's got great speed who can account for the running of this quarterback.
And he converts the extra point. Wilson is lined up to kick this one off. They'll bring him down at the 30-yard line.
Brad, this is my kind of game. I love seeing this kind of production and the way these quarterbacks are playing. Both teams are challenging both of these defenses.
They need to show a little giddy up now, because if they don't start eating into this deficit, they could easily fall out of the game.
And they'll get him in the backfield. From their own 26-yard line. Second down.
Ready!
And he's hit immediately. Throws right. Hauls it in as he's pushed out of bounds. Fires out quickly to the tailback. Knocked out of bounds
at about the 35. As we expected coming into this game, this one appears to be under control. 21-7, Ducks. Back to the action now here in the second quarter. Quick throw out to the receiver. And he's tackled at the 19. Play number 9 of this current drive.
Roger, roger. Hey, watch that,
watch that. They'll bring him down just outside the goal line.
Right here, right here. Hey, watch that, watch that. Just like
ready!
He's under pressure. Slings it out there incomplete.
The offense is staying on the field. It's all or nothing. Here we go. Looks to a receiver. Touchdown. PAT. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He makes it to the 32-yard line.
Both these defensive coordinators have got to be going crazy right now. We've had four straight possessions in which these offenses have put points on the board.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Oregon is up a score. He's into the open field. And down he goes, right around the 48-yard line. They go with the option and pick up the first down.
Yeah, and that was a situation where the quarterback knew he could pick up the first down if he kept it himself. That's a good decision.
Throws incomplete. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
From their own 48-yard line, it's second down. But it's incomplete. Greer is back deep to return the punt. Signals for a fair catch.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays.
Halfback's got him on the quick throw. Brought down at the 31-yard line.
This offense is about 3 feet away from that first down marker.
Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. And they make the stop at the 11-yard line.
Hey, look 48. Hey, go back to 48 right now. Let's go.
just don't see this very often anymore in college football. That is their fifth first down on this drive alone. They have great rhythm right now as an offense. And look at that poor defense. They're looking over to the sidelines to the defensive coordinator for some help. They need to change things up.
And he's level at the two-yard line. Joseph gains about 5 yards on the play.
They're at the two. It's second down.
Touchdown, Cougars.
They'll line up for the extra point in an attempt to tie the game.
He makes the PAT.
It was an 11-play, 88-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown.
An amazing drive for this offense. Outstanding execution. If you're the defense, you've got to do something to try to change things up to get this quarterback out of sync.
The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off.
He'll take it from the two. Tackle at the 25-yard line.
Well, the points are coming like snow flurries in the winter.
And we still have time to go here in the first half. Who knows? Maybe we can get a couple more touchdowns out of this.
You always want to go in the locker room with momentum. So as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays.
They'll line up with five wide receivers. Gets it out quickly. He's taken down
around the 38-yard line.
They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a five wide outlook. And he's taken down around the 47-yard line. So it's second down and about 2 yards to go.
The quarterback and his receiver make a great play here and convert on an early down.
He scrambled, and they got it.
The offensive line has to at least slow the guy down a little bit. He was in there in no time.
They come out in an empty backfield. He's going to try and scramble. And he's tackled at the 45-yard line. And that was a nice pickup by the quarterback.
Brad, I think this guy is amazing. He has an uncanny ability to scramble, and it showed right there on that play.
He's scrambling, runs with it, and he's got room. He's brought down in the open field.
And they're going to put six DBs on the field to counter that five receiver look.
Now he's scrambling. Now he's going to run and watch out. Now it's first and goal as he's knocked out after a nice gain. They'll get the first down.
He made the correct decision to tuck it and go.
First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line.
He's on the run.
Oregon's going to have to use their second time out of the half.
Here's the eighth play of the series. Tackle around the 3 yard line. A gain of eight on the carry. Scrambling around. He gets sacked on the play.
Coaches don't like it when their quarterback gets hit like that. Don't be surprised to see the old coach get on his lineman to protect the quarterback a little bit better.
It's fourth down. This isn't much more than an extra point. Oregon could take the lead with this field goal. Kicks up,
And he got it.
Even though they gave up a field goal here, that defense is feeling pretty good about themselves right now. It could have just as easily been a touchdown.
Well, we've got a barn burner here. And at the end of the first half, our score, 24-21, Oregon.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game.
Points aplenty in that first half. Both teams going up and down the field. Still have a tight game here. David, what do you think the offense's reaction to the defensive struggles has been?
There's always frustration as a player because you feel like on the other side you're holding up your end of the bargain. But at the same time, there's also those days when it's reversed and you're doing a bad job and the other side's doing a good job. So I think you try to stay positive. You try to keep everybody up and just realize that we get a few stops and this offense continues to roll. You know, we can roll them right out of the building. So it's positive. It's trying to be upbeat, even though right now your defense is not putting anything out there that you like.
That's going to do it for David and me here in the studio. Time to get you back to the game. Brett and Kirk ready to take you home in the second half.
And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set for the second half. They bring him down, and they bring him down hard on that one.
Both teams have really answered the bell here in the third quarter, Kirk.
Well, exciting to see what these offenses have been able to do here. Be able to come out and score in your first drive tells you a lot about what they did during the half.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing.
And he tackles him hard at the 26. He steps out at the 29-yard line. He's at midfield, and down he goes around the 48-yard line. And they push him out at about the 33-yard line.
Play like that, I wouldn't be the least bit surprised if they went to the air again.
It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker. Open man, quick strike, and he can't pull it in. And this is the eighth play of the drive. It out to about the 10. Finds his man and they take him down immediately. Great. Gains 4 yards on that reception. The 7-yard line. Who there?
quickly, and he's got his receiver for the touchdown. Play ever developed nicely.
Well, it's all about the receiver on this play. He beat his man off the line and then ran a perfect route. All he had to do after that was make the catch.
And he converts the extra point. An 11-play, 81-yard drive, and they put up 7 points.
This quarterback has really demonstrated a tremendous amount of ability and leadership today. I'd be very surprised if he didn't continue to play well.
From the 7, and he's taken down at the 28. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Gains his way to the 36-yard line. At midfield.
Brought down with only one man to beat.
Nice play, baby.
Let's make these babies cry all the way back home. Man. Let's make these babies cry.
300
Got it complete, and he's out of bounds. Makes it out to about the 7. He passes it. We've got 2nd and goal. Ball on the 7-yard line. Touchdown, Ducks. Trying to go up by 3. They'll kick the extra point. And he tacks on the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Takes it from the 6. He makes it to the 25-yard line.
Boy, this has been a fun game to watch, going back and forth and back and forth. It's almost like watching a tennis match here. Whoever has the ball last, my guess, will be the team that wins it.
A touchdown was the end result of their last drive, as this offense moved the ball very well with their passing game.
Great passing was the key for the offense the last time they had the ball. They were able to pick apart the defense and get down the field for a touchdown.
Very good tackle in space. That's a great tackle at the 42-yard line. Gets it. He's in space. He's pushed out of bounds at the 34-yard line. Hits him hard at the 18-yard line. receiver. It's second and 10. Ball on the 18-yard line. Throws quick to the receiver, and it falls incomplete. Five wide. Fires out to his wideout. Touchdown, Washington State. For Graves, he registers another touchdown pass, his third.
What I'm noticing more and more about this guy is he's very patient with the ball, and it's resulting in some nice scores, just like we've seen today.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He's to the 20. They'll bring him down at the 31-yard line. So their last drive resulted in 6 points. Do you think we'll see the same result on this one?
They ran the ball extremely well on their last drive. And until this defense figures out how to stop it, I think they'll have no problem moving the ball down the field. Just didn't have any room to work on that play. The defense just suffocated him there.
From their own 30-yard line, it's third down. He throws it. The defender had his hands on it, but it's incomplete. McCall is the punter. Greer takes it to 32, and he makes it out to about the 41-yard line. And what a game it's been for this quarterback, Kirk.
Well, this is an example of this quarterback just really being able to go out and show his competitive spirit. And each time he plays, he puts that out on display.
I'm sure these fans would love to see him add to his stats right here and get a little more separation on the scoreboard. They moved the ball very effectively on their last drive, which ended with a touchdown. The defense has been talking it over on the sideline, trying to make some corrections. Let's see if they can stop him this time.
I love to watch a quarterback when he can really get into sync with his wide receivers. These guys have worked all week on their preparation to attack this defense, and right now it's really paying off.
Washington State holds a 4-point lead. The stop at the 30. Deep ball, laying it out there. Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 30. Slings it, and they get him in the backfield for a loss. Taken back a yard.
Pretty good stand there. They weren't fooled at all by the offensive play call.
That's three down and one to go. The Cougars lead it by 4. Great three quarters of action, tight ball game, and now it's the fourth quarter, and this will decide it.
Here we go!
We might look
back on this game when it's all over and say that's the point where they won the football game with that stop.
After the sack, it's now fourth and long. Wood awaits the snap.
This one will go into the end zone, and they'll bring it out to the 20.
Things aren't tied, but they might as well be. It's this drive that could really dictate the tone for the last quarter.
Makes a catch, and he's got nowhere to go.
Taken down at the 23-yard line.
Here's a screen pass. Gets it to the back.
Tackle made at the 38.
He's hit and taken down. Just throws this one away.
Second down and 10 to go.
Ball on the 33-yard line. He's knocked out of bounds,
right around the 26-yard line.
He's tackled right around the 14-yard line.
Tackled right around the 6-yard line.
And he has it on the corner. He's in. Touchdown. And they take the lead.
So the kicker will line up here and try to give his team a 3-point lead with this extra point.
He makes the PAT.
The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off.
Greer fields it at the 11.
Got the corner.
He makes it to the 32-yard line.
Washington State's given them all they can handle today, and they're still not done.
Yeah, let's remember, they were a heavy underdog coming into this game, and here they are, under 3 minutes to go, with the football, a chance to put a drive together, and who knows, maybe they can take the lead.
Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game.
Caught with room to work. Steps out of bounds at the 38-yard line.
Less than 3 minutes in the game.
Short pass, middle of the field.
And he's taken down at the 41-yard line.
Let's set a tone, fellas. Let's set a tone. Hey, alert 48.
And he's tackled after positive yardage.
Eagle!
quick out to his receiver. And he's shoved out of bounds at the 36. From the 19-yard line, first down. Throws a bullet. The defender had it and then dropped it. The defense really missed a golden opportunity there.
That's what separates a good player from a great player. When you have a chance like that, you need to take advantage of it.
Here's the eighth play of the series. And he's level at the 27-yard line.
Well, they've converted one third down play on this drive, but now they're faced with a third and long. Just under 2 minutes in the game.
He's got to throw it in a hurry. Well, that's just a huge stop right there here late in the fourth quarter in a game this tight. That might be one we look back on later and say that won the ball game.
Fourth quarter.
And they're going to have to give the ball back after going for it on fourth and long.
Not much you can do there. You got to go for it and give yourselves a chance.
You aren't going to convert many fourth downs against this defense. That's a really good stop.
Here we are late in the fourth quarter in a very important and a very tight football game. And who's going to come to the forefront? We'll see who's got the most leadership.
He's out to the 30. Tackle at the 42.
I think the defense is starting to be concerned about the outcome of this game. That was a huge first down by the offense, and at this point, you wonder if the defense can make a play to get their own offense back out on the field.
Gets to around the 42.
Huge first down right there by the offense, Brad. At this point, they're just trying to work the clock and preserve the victory.
Up the middle for a nice game. James gets 6 yards on the carry. We're down to our final minute of this ball game. They'll bring him down around the 21-yard line. And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. Nothing more demoralizing for a defense than seeing the opposing quarterback take a knee. James, the star of the game, Kirk, it's as simple as that. He played a great game. The whole team played a great game, and they won it. That's the important part.
Yeah, Brad, he had an excellent game, and really kind of what we expected coming into today's game for him to be able to step up and show that he's one of the top players in the country, and he really didn't disappoint at all. While individual accolades are great, I'm sure he'll tell you the fact that his team came away with a victory is really the most important aspect of this game.